Now let's look at the hybridization effect. The hybridization effect, the definition is this, that the higher the S character in an acid, remember that we talked about S character when we were talking about hybridization. Remember we were like saying like 25% S character would come from sp3, where you have like an S and you have three P's, so then 25% of the entire thing is S, and that would be the S character, okay? And the reason is because the S orbital is the one that's closest to the nucleus. Remember, it's the smallest. So the more S character you have, the closer the lone pairs are going to be held to the nucleus, and it's going to make the conjugate base more stable because you're going to hold those electrons tighter to the positive, and it's going to be a little bit more stable. So if we were to think about the acidity trend, what it would look like, and by the way, just go ahead and add a stick there if you don't have one already. So for the acidity trend, what it would be is that SP, okay, has would have 50% S character because it's basically one part S, one part P. SP2 would have 33% S character, and then SP3 would have 25% S character. Now let's look at the pKa's underneath. I want you guys to draw in the pKa's so you guys can remember what they are and you guys can see how this trend is affected. So what was the pKa of an SP hybridized CH? It was 25. What was the pKa of SP2? Remember, this is alkyne, alkene, and alkane. SP2 would be 44. And then what was SP3? It was 50. Okay? So you can see how as my S character gets higher, as my S character is increasing, my acidity is also increasing. Does that make sense? So as your S character is getting bigger, the amount of the whole hybrid orbital is S, the more acidic you get.